this is H.C. Bailey, and welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy XII! Since last time, I decided to spawn these Wendigos here, as well as Pit Fiends who were around here before. The reason is because, the way you spawn them here, for those who missed it last time, what you need to do is basically zone, or go back two rooms from the entrance of this area, and then go forward two rooms, and just keep on doing that over and over and over again until you get Wendigos and Pit Fiends to spawn instead of the Strikers and Imps who were here before. And then once you do that, and you kill all the enemies in here, then you get this guy to spawn, the Cubus. I don't know what that means, but whatever. Why don't you use a Cura on all of us? Good thing I got that handkerchief going. But anyway, so yeah, that's how you spawn this rare game. Took me about 15 minutes to get the Wendigos and other guys to spawn there. Actually, why don't you do that? Use a handkerchief yourself. Or Balthier, could you lend her yours again? There we go. Yeah, so it keeps on trying to do that over and over and over again. But otherwise, I mean, once you get the Wendigos to spawn, then the rare game itself is relatively easy to get to spawn. You got Smelling Salts going for you, but we might want to keep you alive. I was going to say we might want to use an antidote on you, but no! There we go. Wow, this guy's really going all out there. We almost got him. Is he weak to anything? I can't tell if he is. He might be weak to water, because Vanilla's dealing some pretty good damage. Well, regardless, we're all set and ready to go, so we got him. Let's take a look at that in the Clan Primer there. Also, since last time, there were a few licenses that I got, so I'll show you those in just a moment. There's the Tarrasque, who I heard is much tougher in Dungeons & Dragons than in this game. Or whatever reference you guys were talking about, I don't know. I've thought about getting into Dungeons & Dragons, but I don't know, it just seems enormously complicated to me. I mean, I'd like to have something to do to get out of the house more often. Yeah, I know, I stay in the house a lot. Yeah, I know, that's a real shock to you viewers. I know my local hobby shop has, you know, gaming nights where they do Dungeons & Dragons and such, but I don't know how to get into the group or anything like that, so. But anyway, now that we've done that, then now we can move on with the plot today. Oh, I gotta show you those licenses that I got, too. Yeah, let's just skip this. I showed you that last time. Yeah, if only you could do that in real life with elevators. Just skip them. That'd be awesome. But anyway. Okay, so now, I've already got the licenses for everyone except Pinello. We want to get Focus, which is basically like Serenity, but for physical attacks. And some Shield Block licenses. Someone was asking me, H.C. Bailey, does Serenity help with Katana since part of its damage is magic-based? And the answer is no. No, you have to use Bravery and the Focus license for that. So, and we also want to get these two. Mostly for the Thief's Cuffs and the Bowline Sash, which the latter of protects you from the Confusion status, which can be pretty nice in the next dungeon we're going to be going through. But not today. So anyway, I got those licenses for everyone there. We'll be getting some other licenses soon enough, viewers. Soon enough. I really hope I have enough money for everything, because there's just so much to buy coming up. Oh well. I'll keep an eye on it. Stretch! I like that animation.
Capital, more like a sewer. Even empires have need of sewers. The runoff from Arcades proper pools here. Those who lack papers to live in the city itself.
Let me guess, we're going to have to go through a large sewer dungeon to get in.
And the fallen who would be mighty. Their eyes never leave Arcades.
I guess it must be a lot nicer than this place.
Oh, to be sure. Arcades reeks of a different filth.
Money.
Let's be off. We can follow our noses to Draclaw.
They're great! Just follow your nose. Sorry, I get my children's cereal catchphrases mixed up all the time. But anyway, I got airships and everything going on here. Kind of reminds me of Chicago for some reason. But anyway, if he'll spawn... There he is! Yeah, trying to trick you there. But, I'm sure that's not true. But, we do want to buy some things from him. So, let's start with Fuzzy Miters. I don't know that I'll ever really use those, but, no. But I might as well hold on to them just in case. Bowline Sashes we definitely want to get. Those are really nice. And most importantly, the Embroidered Tippets, which doubles your experience. So, basically, I'll equip those in a moment. But basically, well, let me take a moment to sell my excess loot and everything else off-screen. I'll be right back. Okay, we're doing okay on money right there. But anyway, whenever you talk to someone around here, it'll reveal their real name or something like that. Like, it'll say Arcadian Gentry or something like that. But then you learn their real name, Precocious Girl. So if you want to learn everyone's name, well, you gotta talk to everyone. So, I'm gonna kinda skim through this, mostly just to reveal their names, in case for later. But, yeah, So, if you really wanna read them, all of this stuff, pause, but I may not even talk to everyone. I'm just kinda going around, it says Arcadian Vulgar, but, you know, now her name's Cautious Woman, so. If for some reason I'm looking for her later, I can find her. So, yeah, okay, I'm not going to talk to everyone. Oh, there is someone around here that I want to talk to. Let's see what's going on back here. What the? You guys are holding a cockatrice here! What? It's a talking cockatrice? Huh. That's weird. Oh, you're one of the cockatrices from Giza, huh? Back in that farm. Huh. Remember that for later, viewers. But, I wonder what he or she's doing way out here. Huh. You have no hope! Well, we'll remember that for later, viewers. The reason we can talk to the cockatrice is because of... what is it? We got that Feather of the Flock item after that Gill... That wasn't the Gill Snapper, was it? One of those turtle hunts that we killed. I get all the turtles mixed up. But, anyway. Okay, now I kind of want to start talking to people because there's someone who has something to do with getting into Arcades. Yeah, so I'm just going to kind of skim through these real quickly. Maybe it's not here. I think it's later on. Yeah, you know what? I think it is later on. It's not around here. At least I think it is. Ah, hey, we got these Moogles here. It's gonna turn you into a gourmet? I don't know what they're talking about, viewers. Got me on that one. Got a nice highway for the poor here. Man, even the poor people got it nice here. At least I got sun. Unlike where we live. Okay, yeah, this is where I want it to be. Okay, now I forget exactly which person says what I need to... the information that I'm looking for. So I'm just going to kind of skim through these people and try and figure it out. The old-fashioned way. There's a lot of people. How can you expect me to remember what everyone says? Ah, here it is. Okay. It's a bag of coin in a barrel there. Ah, okay. So yeah, remember that for later, viewers. Like, today, but you'll see. How's it going? Oh, there you go. I wonder who could have done that. Okay, well, that's everything around here. Oh, yeah, there's one more guy I want to talk to here. Furmon, huh? Remember him for later, viewers. You are taking notes, right, viewers? I've got like 38 pages of notes for this LP. Biggest LP I've ever done for notes, so. Oh, okay. How important could it possibly be? Oh, okay. Sorry. Okay, let's move along then. Okay, how's it going? Jewels, huh? Vern? No, just jewels. Oh, well, I'll keep that in mind. Remember him for later, viewers. Yeah, I did a lot of research for this LP. Holy cow. What was I thinking? We're 60... Well, I mean, we're at 60, 30 hours into the game. It took me 80 hours to 100% the game, just to put it that way, viewers. Suffer, viewers. I'm teasing. But yeah, we've got a long way to go still. Lots of side quests and such. What's a street ear? How's it going? Kind of reminds me of Shadow. Well, we just gotta get past one guard. That's it. Oh, absolutely! That's the best logic I've ever heard this whole game. Why not? Man, it would really suck if you didn't have the money for all this stuff. I call this meeting to order. Trying to do my best Arcadian accent there. Oh, okay, I'll keep that in mind. Now, anyway, remember what we were... So basically what he's telling you is, remember that guy who said someone stole his money there? And remember that we found someone else who said he found some money in that barrel there? Well, that's how we gotta get past the guy. We gotta tell him about that. So, you can remember something for 5 minutes, can't you? Oh, okay. I think that's all we need to do. So, let's get back here. So, let's see what happens now. Now, what's going to happen now? He's gone mad! Oh. So yeah, we start a fight. Apparently the guards gotta break it up, and now we can get past them. Alright. Hmm. Valfir's last name is Bonanza, by the way, just so you know. That's what he was talking about there. But, all right, there we go. Ah, we finally made it. How many episodes did it take us to get here? Didn't seem like it took that long. But now we can finally advance the plot. You think we're really going to advance the plot today, viewers? No, we are. We are. I'm just jacking.
You're gaping like a fish out of water.
I'm just checking out the city. Even if it is the Empire.
You've changed, Vaughn. You were always marching to your own beat. Almost like you were impatient, even. In a good way.
Maybe it's because I've seen more now. Never imagined I'd ever come this far away from home. Hey, Lars is here in the city, isn't he? He's a tough one. I wonder how he's doing.
You always were a soft touch, Vaughn.
What do you mean by that? Don't answer that, viewers.
You know what's amazing? I always thought I'd go my whole life without meeting people like the Princess or Lord Larsa. And here we are in the capital.
I know.
Yeah, it's almost like there's no reason for us to be around.
Good, Vaughn. You've come to understand the difficulties of serving royalty.
Hey, I'm just along for the ride.
That was...
Well, at least he understands.
Right, let's get moving.
Hey, don't change the subject.
Aw, right. Isn't that cute? They think they're talking about me behind my back. Aw. I mean, she has that look on her face, like, what is with that look? I don't know. But anyway. Oh, okay. Now, once again, I'm going to be going, talking to people, and I'm just going to quick talk to them, reveal what their real name is, Music Appreciator, and just move along. Or we could have more dialogue, why not? Oh, well, where are you going? Oh, well, yeah, I suppose he does have his own business to take care of here. Let's see how we're doing around here. Okay, let's not do this here yet. Let's just move along, then. I would like to at least start the next side quest here. First things first, we want to get to the magic shop. Which I think is this way. Yeah, there it is. But anyway, one thing you will want to do, I'm not going to do this on screen, talk to everyone, absolutely everyone around here, and reveal whatever their real name is, because otherwise you're just going to see Arcadian Gentry, or Vulgar, or whatever. So, first things first, let's get some new magic here. Let's see, most importantly, we want to get Aroga, Reflexga. We don't need to get the rest of these, but I'm going to anyway. So, let's see. There's someone else around here, too, that I want to talk to. July! Yeah, remember her? She was back at Nalbana. Oh, so she's another street ear, huh? Oh, well, there we go. But anyway, for talking to her, we get a... whatever that is. I don't know how to pronounce it. But anyway, so yeah, for helping her out, we get that little reward. Rokinmu. No, but you can tell me about it. Otto. Yeah, we were talking to a guy named Otto before, but we can't really do much... Well, could we do that now? Well, I'm not going to, but remember that for later, viewers. I'll go for a little length on today's episode. I just want to start the side quest, at least. Let's see, I think there's a Technic shop around here somewhere. Maybe that's in another district, I forget. No, wait, is that a Technic shop or a Gambit shop? I forget. Yes, it's a Technic shop. All right. Now, I'm not interested in any Technics here. Unless they got charge, because I do want to get charge soon. No, they don't got it. Oh, well. I'll get charge later. But there is one thing that I do want to get here. Or, well, a couple things. Maps! I like having maps. So, yeah, we want to get the Cedar Uplands. Yeah, now we get it after I don't need it anymore. But I'll take what I can get. Alright, there we go. When I said talk to everyone, that doesn't include everyone inside a building or a store or something like that. You don't have to do that. Just talk to everyone outside and reveal their names. So, like I said, I'm going to do that off-screen, but you can do that whenever you want. But anyway, now we want to go down here. There's a lot of... I'm going to list all this stuff that I'm buying here in the video description, just, you know, except for the maps, obviously. But everything else I want to get now. And you know what? There are quite a few licenses that I want to get here, too. So, let's start with that. Let's go with Balthier and Fran, both of whom are behind on their abilities. I think that's where I want to go. But I'm not quite sure. You know what? I'm going to do that off screen. There's some equipment that I want to buy here, but you know what? I'll save that for next time. Because I'm not exactly sure where the licenses are that I want to get. So, okay, well, let's just move along then. What's a chop? What is a chop anyway? A million? We paid 1,500 gil, but a million? I don't think I've ever even gotten a million gil in this game. You're not going to tell us, are you? Okay, sounds like a plan. That doesn't explain what a chop is. What is it, a chop of wood, or... I don't know. Okay. Well, do the best I can. Apparently Fran doesn't trust him very much. Uh-oh, he's coughing. He's a dead man. No, probably not. But now this starts perhaps the most annoying side quest in the game. But anyway, what you gotta do for this side quest is you gotta find someone here who has some sort of problem. And then you gotta find someone else who's in the same area who can solve that problem. So basically what I'm going to do, is, and there's like a whole bunch of them around here. I'm not going to do this on screen. I'm going to do this off screen. Worry not, viewers. But I would recommend looking it up in a walkthrough. So you basically talk to everyone so that way you know what their real name is. Like, talk to this guy and he's an eager crier. So basically reveal everyone's name first so that way you know who's who and whatnot. And then basically talk to one guy who has the problem, talk to another guy who has the solution to that problem, and you'll get a chop for it. And you do this over and over and over again. You can do this up to 28 times, which I would recommend doing, even though you only need 9, because I think if you do all 28, it unlocks another side quest later on, if I recall correctly. So I'm going to take care of all this off-screen, and then we'll find a way to get deeper into Arcades. Next time on Let's Play Final Fantasy XII! This is H.G. Bailey, signing off. Have a good day!